Welcome to this edition of Spotlight. We are at Graden Elementary with Principal Dr. LuAnn Halverstadt. And LuAnn, there's a new routine this year at Graden that's helping to build number sense in math for K through five, different strategies to help with that number sense. Can you share what that is?
Yes, it's called Number Talks, and it's a short 10 to 13 minute routine where students learn how to be flexible with numbers, manipulate numbers, look for mental math strategies that are efficient and accurate.
Well, let's see Number Talks in action and see how it's helping students learn at Graden as we spotlight the Hornets.
Number Talks develops number sense. So if you think about every strand of mathematics, you have to have number sense to be able to do any of those things. So I believe that it's the foundation of that. So if they get that foundation and are able to really talk about their mental math and everything that the strategies that they use, then they're able to apply those strategies to any strand in mathematics.
One example of a number talk is making tens and like, so if you were doing like 30 minus 15, you would do like you could use a strategy with addition, and you could do so like 15 plus what would equal 30.
A number strategy that I like for multiplication is mainly a distributive property. Say you would 7 times 3, and then you break that up into 4 and 3, and then you do 4 times 3 is 12, then plus 3 times 3 is 9, and then 12 plus 9 would equal 21.
Sometimes I break it apart, like say it's 3 times 25, maybe it's like 3 times 20 and then 3 times 5. It makes it easier.
In the primary grades, we use quick images that are projected on the board, and we have a student-led discussion where the teacher is the facilitator, and we get to have the students share out their strategies, and they get to use their hand signals to indicate their thinking, which gives teachers an opportunity to see at a glance which students are understanding the problem on the board and which students need a little more assistance.
I like Number Talks, and it's really fun, and we get to share strategies, and it's like really like gets my brain going.
It keeps everybody engaged in the process, even if they're not the one sharing out at the time.
I like to listen to other people's strategies.
In the upper grades, we focus more on the four computational aspects, so adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing, and as they continue to work through those operations, finding more and more complex problems with larger and larger numbers is kind of our focus. By the time kids get through fifth grade, they may be working with fractions and decimals as well.
It helps me do like bigger numbers and like adding and subtracting bigger numbers.
It helps me get ready for the day mathematically, and it helps me get quicker when doing math.
It really creates really rich opportunities for mathematical discourse. So kids get to talk about, how did I approach this problem? What was my methodology, my strategy, and how do I know that my answer is reasonable? Or how did I realize that my answer wasn't reasonable, and how was I able to revise my thinking after hearing other students sharing their strategies?
I think that is very important because I think everyone learns from Number Talks. It makes it a lot easier. I can tell like sometimes all the kids are like, oh. And sometimes that's just when someone introduces a new strategy and it helps everyone.
I think the biggest thing I've noticed with Number Talks is that it really draws out those reluctant mathematicians. So kids who might normally feel like, I'm not sure that I have the skills or I'm not sure that I'm able to solve this problem, they're able to bounce ideas off of other students and kick those ideas around in their head as they hear other children talking about them, and then try to implement those strategies in their own work later on.
You have the kids who are your really high flyers in math, and it comes so quick to them. They've probably already developed a lot of number sense, and someone has probably already taught them mental math strategies. And then you have the ones that are reluctant mathematicians, but it literally bridges that gap.
I like it when she puts my name up on the board because it feels like you're saying, I can do this too. It's not just this strategy, I can also do this, this, and this.
And the biggest thing I tell them is it's listening. It's listening to other people's strategies so that you can build upon each other and really see that our brains all work differently when it comes to math.
I like the different ways, like everybody does it a different way when we do them.
Kids are able to apply their ideas and their thinking about computation to new and novel problems and to approach them in a variety of different ways, think about strategies that they may not have known previously and identify what makes a strategy accurate and efficient compared to just something that gets me the right answer.
One of my NWAs, like math tests, it was doing like a really hard question and I like had no idea, but then I just calmed down, broke it down, put it all together. And there I had my strategy and it was done.